iOS 18 brought some big updates to help you get things done, from completely customizing the control center, powerful new tools in Apple Notes, Reminders, and if you got an iPhone 16, you have an action button and camera button that you can customize. So here's my current setup for control center, widgets, shortcuts, and more to help me be even more productive. One of the big changes in iOS 18 is a completely customizable control center. This main control center page is now a mix of shortcuts, HomeKit scenes, and actions that I use every day. And there's even a new shortcuts action to toggle the control center. So now I can back tap on my phone twice and launch or hide the control center, which on the Pro Max size phone, it's getting a little farther away, has been a big help. I'll show you how to do that in a second. Once you update to iOS 18.1, you'll actually be able to have Wi-Fi and Bluetooth controls as individual toggles. That's what I have up here, along with orientation lock and silence. I have some often used smart home controls here for ceiling fans, brightness and volume, and now we've run into some smart home scenes and shortcuts. I didn't want to have the Apple Passwords icon on a home screen, so I've added that as an open app feature here, and it'll go right to Apple Passwords. With the new additions to Control Center, Apple made it even easier in iOS 18 to create these individual app shortcuts. So just search for shortcuts and you'll see the open app feature here. You can select an app and then you can add that anywhere in your Control Center. I have that here for passwords. I also created one for settings, which I go into often, but I also don't want that on a homepage. And I also have app shortcuts for Kino, the video recording app I use, and for calculator. Now, when it comes to smart home devices and scenes, I have my garage door I can open and close right here. And these four icons are actually HomeKit scenes, where you can set a custom icon. And this is all for here in my studio. My office work scene, which I can start in the morning, opens my shades, turns on my ceiling fan. When I'm done working, which shuts off everything here in the studio. I have lots of commands for setting colors and filming, but this icon right here, that's my done recording scene, which turns off my filming gear, turns on my ceiling fan again, and then a good night scene here. Low power mode, focus modes, screen recording, screen mirroring, flashlight. But then down here, I have some custom app actions I use pretty often. This far left one is bare notes. I can tap that, and that will automatically create a new bare note ready for me to type. And remember, Control Center can be accessed in any app, which makes this even more powerful. This icon right here is actually Shareshot. It's now my favorite way to share screenshots of my iPhone. And this icon here in Control Center is actually a shortcut, where it takes the last screenshot that I captured, automatically formats it, and I can quickly share it right here. Super fast way to share good-looking screenshots. I'll go into all these shortcuts actions in just a moment, because the last thing here in my Control Center is actually the Apple TV button. As you can see, this is not the typical remote. That's because this is another shortcut where I can choose what room I'm watching in. Then I can tap a room, it'll wake that Apple TV and automatically send me into the remote app with the proper Apple remote already chosen. That also does a little more in my family room scene where I have a Philips Hue gradient light strip and a home theater, and I'll show you that in a second. By the way, if you're trying to be more productive, I highly recommend trying Sanebox. Sanebox is an AI-driven email management tool that saves the average user 2.5 hours of time per week by seamlessly organizing and filtering emails. I did a whole dedicated video on Sanebox, but I've been using it personally now for the last few months, and it's amazing. First of all, every day I try to get to inbox zero, especially by the end of every week, and the only way I can keep this up is by using Sanebox. You'll see here Sanebox integrates with your iCloud email, Fastmail, Gmail, Outlook, whatever email providers you have, and you see it creates these folders called Sane Later and Sane News, and it keeps my inbox clean and focused on the important emails. Plus it has this really cool feature called Sane Black Hole, so if there's ever a sender that I just never want to see again, I can just move an email to Sane Black Hole, and then Sanebox will send any future messages from that sender to the black hole. Also, if you use stock iOS mail like I do, there's not really a proper snooze feature where an email will disappear from your inbox, but Sanebox has a tool for that too. You can do Sane next week or Sane tomorrow, and Sanebox will filter that email to these folders and then bring it back up in a week, rather than just the Apple Remind Me Later feature. The Sanebox setup is quick and easy. You just authenticate with your iCloud, Google, or Fastmail accounts. And like I mentioned, it works with all email clients. There's zero hidden fees, premium customer support, and they value your privacy. Your information is never sold to anyone. Go to try.sanebox.com/beardfm and you actually get $25 credit towards whatever plan you choose. That's try.sanebox.com/beardfm. The link is also down in the video description. I know you'll love Sanebox. Again, I've been using it for months and I'm going to keep paying for it personally. It is that valuable and you'll never miss an important email. Now, back to some productivity tips. So like I mentioned, I have a shortcut to toggle Control Center and also Shareshot. I also forgot to mention I have a home ETA shortcut. When I run that, it gets my current location, gets my driving distance to home, and then pre-populates a text to my wife. It says be home in 2 seconds because, well, I'm already here. And I also have a Fantastical control where I can create a new event just by tapping this here in Control Center. This Control Center setup has made me so much more productive, plus I can have additional pages for like my Now Playing widgets, and I still have the connectivity page if I need to access things like AirDrop or Airplane Mode. Now if I jump into shortcuts real quick, let me show you a couple actions that I've been using. Again, this is an 18.1, the dev beta, but it should be coming soon to everyone. Show Control Center is a new action where you can show, hide, or toggle it. And if you want to use Shareshot to make those beautiful screenshot posts for social media, I actually just have a one-action shortcut that says open Shareshot with the most recent screenshot. And that's what I have down here in my Control Center, so I can just quickly create that image in a few seconds. Now, before I get to the action button, camera control, and Apple Notes and Reminders, if you swipe over to the Today view, I use this as a massive shortcuts launcher. And these are all actions I use pretty much every day. Intercom options, and this will send intercom messages automatically to HomePods throughout my house. Share primary text shortcut actually gets the latest episode from Apple Podcasts, Spotify, and YouTube, and automatically generates text for me to share. I have a bunch of Tesla shortcuts because I just bought an 11-year-old Model S. If you'd like to see that journey, check out this video above. And get subscribed because I have this device, which supposedly adds CarPlay to a Tesla, so I'm going to be trying that out soon too. I have some shortcuts down here for actually filming video. My recording video shortcut, this actually sets my brightness, sets it to dark mode, and then opens the settings screen to set auto display lock never, and then also sends me to the accessibility page so I can turn off auto brightness. That allows me to film my phone screen, it won't turn off, and it won't change brightness. Then I have another done recording workflow, and that actually raises the brightness. I can go back here to set auto lock to 30 seconds, and then turn auto brightness back on. Then down here, I have a couple shortcuts to watch things, also keeping track of when we fed the snake, and just a simple open shortcut shortcut, just to quickly get to shortcuts. I know, that's pretty meta. By the way, that watch something shortcut that I have here in my control center, that's that bottom right icon right here. It starts with a shortcuts menu where I choose what room I'm watching in. And then for the bedroom and living room, it just wakes the Apple TV, sets a HomeKit scene, which dims the lights, and then shows the remote control on my iPhone for that particular Apple TV. But in my family room where I have a Philips Hue sync box, I have a couple actions there which turns the box on, starts syncing, and this is kind of our we're going to watch a movie scene and everything just sets automatically. So that's Control Center and some shortcuts. Now let's talk about the action button. I have an entire video where I talked about helpful shortcuts for the action button. You can check it out up here. But if you want, you can set it so the action button shows the Control Center. That's cool. On a Pro Max phone, the action button is almost as far away as Control Center. So instead, you can do something like show a folder. And if you have an action button folder, then your most used shortcuts can appear whenever you press the action button. For some of those actions, I have things like wake the Apple TV and remote, toggle my garage door, open ChatGPT to a voice conversation, and even a shortcut that quickly jumps back to the action button settings. Again, check out my video on the action button shortcuts for building all those or just downloading them. You can also use the action button as a toggle, like for opening and closing your garage door directly, or dictate a note and then have ChatGPT summarize it and put it into bullet points and then create a new Apple note. I have an entire video on ChatGPT shortcuts that are really cool to use with the action button. You can check those out above and the links in the description. Now let's talk about widget stacks. This is my main home screen when I'm working. No focus mode is activated, this is just the default. And I'm also a one home screen kind of person. It's just the home screen, app library, and the Today view. I have a whole video on my one home screen setup, you can check it out above. But these two widget stacks are actually stacks. So I have Pocket Cast for starting my latest episode. Scroll down and I have Things. This is helpful because I can check off a to-do right here from the widget, and I use Things and Reminders together, and that keeps track of personal to-dos in Reminders, and then work tasks in Things. I like my dual task setup. It's a long story. I think I did a video on that as well. Underneath that, I have Any List, which is tonight's dinner plan if I need to get any groceries, and then I also have my Tesla widget here in the stack. One thing I'll say about widget stacks. They're really only helpful if you know what's in the stack and where in the stack it is. For instance, when this stack is by default on the Pocket Cast widget, I know I can swipe down and see if my Tesla's charging or not, and then swipe back and be back on the main widget. Likewise, I know it's Things, Reminders, and then Any List, so if you have too many widgets in a stack, I find it less useful. In the same way, I know this weather widget right underneath is my Fantastical schedule, so I can swipe down, see upcoming events and the full month calendar, and then swipe back up just to see the weather. And I know underneath that, I actually have the new Contacts widget, which shows me my family so I can tap one and quickly text or call them, and also shows me their location right there in the widget. Now when it comes to focus modes, I do have a different home screen when I change to my evening focus. Here's one of Basic Apple Guy's latest wallpapers, and when I go into my evening focus, you'll see it's a different home screen. Here on my evening and weekend home screen, I've replaced some apps like putting the journal app there, and I also use Widgetsmith's app to have a photo right here in a widget. Static photo, it's the same every time. I have my Tesla widget, and I also have the built-in Apple Photos widget because that actually rotates and sometimes shows me nice pictures I don't remember. Then under the Pocket Cast widget, I actually have the month calendar, just in case I need to look up a date, and AnyList widget as well. Then at the top, I actually have the same stack, Weather widget, Fantastical, and Contacts. But let's go back into the filming focus mode and take a look at Apple Notes. Even without Apple Intelligence, Apple Notes has some huge upgrades. For instance, we can start a new note, and if we hit the paperclip icon down here, we can start a new audio recording. Now, when I start recording, not only is this recording the audio and it will be saved to the note, but I can also start transcribing what I'm saying, and the Apple Note will catch up, and I'll have an entire transcription for everything I say. Like in this video, we're talking about the control center, shortcuts, home screen setups, and more to boost your productivity. So there's my full transcription right there. I'm going to press pause. That'll stop transcribing. I'll hit done. And now the transcription and audio file is here in Notes. This is not Apple Intelligence. This is just built into iOS 18. Also, if you want the full transcription in the note, you can tap and hold, hit the three dots here at the top, and now you can add the full transcript to the note or copy the transcript, which you can then bring over to ChatGPT and get a summary. You can also search the transcript here or share the audio file. I'm going to add the transcript to the note, and then it will automatically be selected here. Now, I will show you one quick Apple Intelligence feature. Again, this is in the iOS 18.1 beta if you're on an iPhone 15 Pro or newer. I can hit the new Apple Intelligence symbol in the toolbar, and now you have the writing tools come up where you can proofread or rewrite, but I'm actually just going to choose the key point summary. Apple Intelligence is going to process it for a moment, and now I have some bullet points based on the transcript I just recorded. Now, again, if you don't have Apple Intelligence, you can bring this over to the ChatGPT app or use one of my shortcuts by scrolling over to the right in the little contextual menu, hit share, and you can use something like summarize text, and this is a shortcut I built with ChatGPT that's running in the background right there, and now I'll get a summary from ChatGPT if I can't do it with Apple Intelligence. And that's what you get from ChatGPT. Another great new feature in Notes in iOS 18 is the ability to have collapsible header sections. So select some text, mark it as a heading, and now you can actually collapse everything underneath this section by tapping the little arrow to the left. Now you can see it collapsed all of that, but if I select the text here where it says Section 2, go to the Formatting Tools, and then tap Heading, now I'll actually have two collapsible sections. I'll collapse Section 1, and then I have Section 2 separately. And when you collapse sections like that, you can actually select, cut, and then move the entire section plus all the contents just by copying and pasting. And you'll see there, all the contents in Section 2 went above it. And now you have the ability to highlight with different colors. Just tap the formatting tools, then the little color tool there, change the font, add the highlight, and now you have color-coded collapsible sections. Now, while Reminders itself didn't get a ton of upgrades, you can see your reminders now in the Calendar app. Not only can you see, but you can also add reminders directly here. When you press the plus button, you can choose Event or Reminder. But one thing I want to remind you of, pun intended, you can actually tap and hold things into the Reminders app, even things like text message conversations. Let's say I want to remind myself to do something when I text a person or about a conversation. I'm going to tap and hold that conversation here in Messages, keep my finger on the screen, open Reminders, and you'll see the little green plus button here. If I let go, this is going to create a new reminder with a link to that text message conversation. I can press that and it'll jump me over. Important work here being done with Wordle and Connections. This also works for websites, so here I am on Beard FM. I'll click and drag from the address bar, keep my finger on the screen, open Reminders, drop it, and now I've attached a URL to a reminder as well. This also works for images and other content that you can click and drag. And don't forget, Reminders is super powerful when it comes to location, reminding you when you arrive home, leave home, or even at a specific place. You can have the reminder appear when you're in a message conversation. Like I'll put ask for money back when I text my friend Steve here. Now when I open my text messages, as soon as I start typing down here in the box, you'll see that reminder pop up as soon as I send another message. Not to mention you can add it to smart lists, add subtasks, and even attach an image all right here in Reminders. All right, and finally I mentioned camera control. I'm going to jump to my settings using Control Center here. And while I have an entire video on it, which you could check it out above, I would encourage you to go to the camera in your settings app, then camera control. You have a couple settings here like double-clicking in order to open the camera if you see it accidentally taking pictures. Also, clean preview. I find that I want to see all the controls in my camera, even if I press the camera control button. So turning this off means the screen and all the controls will stay visible even when you activate the light press for camera controls. Also, coming in iOS 18.1, you'll be able to go to the accessibility settings, go down to camera control, then actually choose if you want to light press and swipe to be active, or just turn off the button entirely. You can toggle that off. And you should try setting it to a lighter setting, which you can do here. You can also test it by pressing the camera control button, and you'll see the little image here is actually going to let you know whether you're doing a light press or clicking it all the way. So you can test whether lighter, default, or firmer is best for you. So that's my setup for Control Center, shortcuts, action buttons, and more. And if you want to learn even more about some productivity tips, especially on the iPad, get subscribed. If you have any questions, leave comments below this video. And if you want to learn about all the 95 plus new features in iOS 18, I have an entire video on that right up here. Or if you'd like to use your new iPhone 16 to film ProRes video, maybe 4K 120, I did an entire setup with a cage and external SSDs, testing 120 frames per second and all of that. You can check the video out right up here. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.